Are you tired of being overcharged and forced into paying a monthly subscription for your Mac and Windows software? Well, if you are, currently we're having a 50% off discount on all the latest Mac and Windows software, such as AutoCAD, SolidWorks, Photoshop, Microsoft Office, and much more. Our 50% off discount will be ending soon, so be sure to text us, Need Software, to 323-405-1341. That's 323-405-1341. We aim to please, so expect 24/7 technical support, the latest premium software, instant software links delivered to your email, and PayPal Buyer's Protection Guarantee.
Super predators. No conscience, no empathy. Love. We can talk about why they ended up that way, but first we have to bring them to heal.
The irony, the government gave us drugs to sniff and smoke, then incarcerated us when we distribute coke. Public housing where the richest folks wear fancy furs, don't name up in the jets with expensive coats. They made a profit off of economics. Would I speak your favorite artist and change the topic? I'm Huey Newton, revolution can't wait to start it. You Cam Newton, was a Panther turned patriotic.
We in the same generation, man. You know, even my brothers were older than me. You know, PX and, you know, Lumumba for years. And, you know, Architect. Those right. My brothers were older than me. They were at least, you know, 5 to 10 years older than me. So, you know, me and Shaft was the babies of the crew, you know what I'm saying, coming in, and we brought X-Clan to the Blackwash movement, you know?
Let's take it back.
Yes.
You going to the foundations right now. Rest in peace, Lumumba.
Yes.
You know, man, like, how did you, I mean, I like to ask this question of a lot of people, but tell me about becoming a fan of hip hop and then becoming, transcending into being a participant. How did that happen?
Well, it started from the turntables for me. You know what I'm saying?
Same here.
You know, I'm from Flatbush, you know, and I was doing block parties, you know, right off, you know, Clarendon Road. And you know, I was just building up my rapport, just loving the records, just loving to play new stuff that was out. There's a record shop right there on Flatbush and Evan Beverly, you know what I'm saying, right there. And I used to go there and get my little vinyl and spin and, you know, and do my thing. And then, you know, I started hearing cats rhyming and whatnot. And I was writing poetry and whatnot, but I wasn't, you know, I didn't write gutter rap and whatnot. I was just writing about our city. Our city is so interesting, you know what I'm saying, in many different ways and whatnot. So my father kind of, you know, banged me into writing about the realism that was happening in New York. He was a cab driver. He owned his own medallion. So he used to move me around and just show me. Yeah. So he used to show me the city from a different side, like, you know, going down to the Bowery and showing me that some of the smartest people in the world may be in there and just took a wrong turn. Rather me build on that and the reform of that, you know what I'm saying, than my clothes or the kind of jewelry I'm wearing or a car or a shorty I got and whatnot. So before Black Watch, I was on that kind of poetry and whatnot. You know, I went through my little amateur rap thing and my talent show and all of this other thing. You know, we all go through it. But you know, but I nailed on what I wanted to do as far as just being a different type of artist. And so when I was introduced to Lumumba, who was starting Black Watch in Brooklyn, it was perfect for me to earn my stripes as a security soldier and then be able to introduce something to them that they didn't have. They didn't have people there that were, you know, that were really putting that message forward. They were positive, but they weren't, you know, they weren't soaked in it and living in it. So training and being able to, you know, to do that at the same time, it was heaven, brother. So, you know, the rest was history. You know, all of that material just spilled like I was possessed. And I was home, you know, and that's what people bear witness to.
So wait a minute. So when did you start studying? Like, when did you come into the knowledge of yourself? You know, because you're saying, you're speaking high science shit that a lot of mother, you know, like some of the shit you're speaking in X-Clan, I got to be honest, like, a lot of that shit was going over to my head till later. Like, I didn't necessarily know what the fucking Ibis was when you were saying it at that time. You know what I mean? Now right. I know about an Ibis and all of that. You see what I'm saying? Even though I was steeped in 5% knowledge, but that doesn't mean I know all of this Egyptian knowledge. And that was a whole next just chamber that y'all brought us into. And you know, but it still was kind of parallel to what we would talk about. So it was just like, oh man, I love these dudes. So how did you get into, like, did Black Watch bring you into that, or did you always already have some of that ammunition coming in?
Well, my family is in the background of knowledge and the craft. You know, we coming from the South, a lot of knowledge was coming through, you know, my elders being part of Masonic orders, and you know, we grow up in this, you know, where they give us shards of knowledge. They can't give you what they study unless you're in the house. But, you know, they give you shards of things. And as a youngster, you pay attention. So, you know, just even going to Sunday school, you know, I went to Concord Baptist across from Boys High in Bed-Stuy. And one day I'm looking at the ceiling and I'm seeing all these symbols. And, you know, and I start writing down the symbols and start breaking them down. You know what I'm saying? Just off simple basics, you know. And then my questions start to be like, you know, why we study nine planets in school and then just heaven and earth in church, you know, and then starting to, you know, to start opening up research. You know, our city is rich with research and we waste a lot of time. You know, we ride the trains and move around and bullshit. But, you know, when you want to know something, there's many places that you can go. There's a lot of, you know, there's a lot of people who would give knowledge if you have patience enough to sit down. So I started moving around different areas in the city and, you know, I would hear about, you know, Sonny Carson. You know, they were more so Black nationalism, which I thought was very interesting because studying all of these cosmic sciences and all these other things and you're not paying attention to the soil you live on, it's kind of backwards. Mm. You know what I'm saying? You're studying millions of years ago and we don't even know what's happening, you know, in our current. So it kind of paced me on what I was studying and whatnot. So back to the knowledge itself, you know, through high school, you know, we all always go through somebody handing us a book of knowledge or something. And, you know, the little pamphlets that used to come into, and, you know, even when York and them had their thing in Brownsville, mm-hmm. you know, he had the little pamphlets. He was having the tablets and the pamphlets. You know,
we called ourselves Nubian, brother, because of Brother York.
Correct, brother.
He's the one that brought that language into the lexicon where we wasn't necessarily calling ourselves Nubian. And after reading some of his pamphlets, that Nubian really stuck to me. I was like, I could trick these motherfuckers into, you know, because African had a negative connotation to it with a lot of people. But if you can almost trick them into calling themselves African by Nubian, you see, that was, you know what I mean? I thought that was a thing. And
exactly.
Dr. York, shout out to Dr. York.
Shout out to Dr. York, man, because he was it was a different thing for. I loved him because he was bold enough to do what he was doing on that side of Brooklyn. You know what I'm saying? One, for the street side, but then he was challenging a lot of the Williamsburg, you know, population over there, you know, with something that was very unapologetically African. The way he was set up was different. You know what I'm saying? It was inspirational, dog. So, you know, that's what I'm saying. In New York, there's pockets of knowledge like that all over. You know, there's Dr. Sabi. He was over by Atlantic Avenue. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you move around, you learn different things, you know, and then you start putting shit together. And, you know, and that's part of the journey of knowledge itself. You know, it's not like you sit down in front of Yoda and he's reading a book to you and shit. You know, you gotta be a traveler. That's part of what, you know, I was kicking the East Blackwoods. You know what I'm saying? We look into the East, you know, we traveling dimensionally Blackwoods, you know what I'm saying? To fill out where this African science is really from. You know what I'm saying? You know, just rewriting history. You know what I'm saying? If it was given to us wrong, you know, I've been studying since fifth grade. You know, my teacher, Mr. Chang, came in a Lutheran school teaching Black history. You know, the first teacher ever, right there off Newkirk and 28th, right there in Flatbush by Foster Park, where I play ball at.
Mm.
All right. He came into a Lutheran school. Now, this is like a divine intervention because, you know, I would never think to learn Black history in, you know, in Lutheran school, private school, you know, they teaching you, you know, that uniform and, you know, singing somebody else's culture and shit like that, man. We didn't have anything that related to Black, and we in a Black neighborhood. We in Flatbush, Brooklyn. You know what I'm saying? So for him to come in, I kept all of those books and I kept reading. I kept studying more. So I started asking different questions in different places and forums. And then when adults see you asking questions, like you said, like key words, you know, Ibis, and you know, you're trying to figure out what it is. You start turning Thoth into Tahuti, and you know, you start really, you know, digging in a little different because you start talking to people and the conversation opens up. So by the time I got to Black Watch, you know, I was very interested in more knowledge. And there were elders from different houses, you know what I'm saying? There were brothers from the nation. There were brothers from Sunni Muslim. There was Nuwabi, not Nuwabian at that time, but I don't know what York's thing was called, Islamic Mission, I think it was probably back then, or the Tabernacle or something. You know what I'm saying? Right. You know, just different brothers from different walks of life always circulated Sonny Carson. So, you know, coming there, I got to kind of slow down and build with each one of them one-on-one, from the martial arts to artillery training, whatever it was. It was a wonderful place. So, you know, when it was my time to do music, brother, from what I was doing with my poetry and my travels just as a youth, and then with the elders, I had no choice but to sound like what I came as. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't going to write about doing a new dance or, you know, or whatever the hell was going on in rap. You know, it's always been a corny strain in hip hop, man. It just, you know, it's never changed to me. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, there has to be the balance, like you said earlier, like there have to be portals that kind of open the doors for the other side of, you know, it shouldn't even be sided, bro. You know what I'm saying? It should all be expression, but they don't let people with balance, you know, more balanced content that's not disrespecting your family. You know what I'm saying? You know, and cursing you out every four bars. You know what I'm saying? There has to be some kind of, you know, mental peace in the craft, man. And, you know, give thanks to your show for opening, you know, doors for artists like myself to speak their piece, man. You know?